We then decided to go across the park and say hi to my sister and go on the next water ride. And there's a video of that, along with some pictures I think I took around that area. I don't know if I did or not, but just in case I didn't. Sorry. I didn't take very many pictures because I was busy pushing my niece around in a wheelchair. We had to rent a wheelchair because my niece has trouble going upstairs, and after a good long week of doing a lot of walking, she was kind of hurting. So yeah, here's a video of us on our way to the other water ride, which is Splash Mountain.
Okay, I got off of Grizzly River Run, and thank God I put my phone away because I got drenched. And we made our way across to Disneyland. We are right now at the Hungry Bear restaurant, because my niece has to use the restroom. We're about to go on Splash Mountain. I'm not gonna hide my phone this time. I'm just gonna go ahead and leave it out, because there's only one area where you really get soaked, and I'm gonna keep my phone, hopefully I keep my phone away from the touching area. Be back.
Here's two videos of us before and after the new Space Mountain attraction. Space Mountain was redone after Sally! Bad girl. No. Down. Sorry, our dog decided to pick up, and she's almost ready to play with a Hello Kitty doll, and no, you don't have a dog play with, you don't have a dog play with Hello Kitty. Sorry, she'll get chewed up. Poor Hello Kitty will get chewed up. But here's the thing about the new Space Mountain. It was actually, I think every year around Halloween they do this new thing where it's called Dark Ghost Galaxy. Oh, it was good. It was really good. But way back in like I think it was like the late 60s, early 70s, they opened up Space Mountain. And I remember from a cast member then, her name was Malou. She told me, you know, when I used to work there, her name was Malou. She was there for opening of Space Mountain. They told the park that the track would have to be replaced in, I think she said, 10 years. That's how long it took them to replace the track. 30 years. I'm not kidding. And, what they were doing during those 30 years is just going in and just welding the cracks. They finally said, look, I think it was Cal OSHA, which is the State Occupational Safety and Health Association, which is the main group that tells you you gotta be safe. You gotta have safety first in this shit. And they told them you have to replace this whole entire track. I remember walking by and seeing that thing gutted. Just completely gutted out. At the time I didn't have a camera phone, I wish I did. I would have taken a picture and shown it to Malou and she probably would have cried. Matter of fact, she did cry when I told her. And yeah, that's what happened there. And Oh, I'm trying to think of what else. Oh, and well, hey, we did it. It got a little faster. They had to dig a little, deeper because the track was a little... I think the original track was, like, maybe that big. I'm doing a rough comparison here. It was that big. The track was that big around. They increased it to that big around, so they had to actually dig deeper and to accommodate it. Oh, man, was it better. Oh, man. I wish I could have taken a picture of me and my niece after it, but just as I got to the photo capture, ready to click the picture off with my phone, it switched to another picture. I'm like, fuck. So, yeah, that's what happened there. And this, the other video, second video I'm going to show, is us on our way to Star Tours. Watch.
Space Mountain, and holy jeez, it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad, it was, oh man. Scary, but fun. As my niece said, I was scared, and I was. Now we're gonna go hit Star Tours. For the first time since they reopened it. And my niece just did bunny ears on me. I hope I can record the Star Wars. Damn! My niece just said no. Oh, that's why it's 3D. Oh well. I guess I'll have to give a little review of it, I guess. Talk to you later.
Okay, now, I said I wasn't able to record inside the attraction because it's 3D. But this next picture, along with the next... Okay, one of the next two pictures. First of all, it's the outside of Star Tours. Second of all, it's the me rocking the 3D glasses, and two videos of us getting ready to go into Star Tours. One is us waiting for the elevator to go up because they have a special entrance for wheelchairs. The other one is the queue line video that they show before you go in. And here you go.
Right now waiting for the elevator, so the elevator just came up. And we are right now waiting to get on Star Tours, the new updated version of Star Tours. I'm not kidding you. My niece does not like cameras.
Not cute.
I'm not on Sunday, I'm not cute.
This is the final call for Star Tours passengers at 8A. Ooh. And this is in 3D. I'm going to go ahead and shut off right now. And that's a recording of something that they are doing before. Okay, he just drops in the bags. Thank God they're not mine.
Excuse me.
Thank you. Okay, that's interesting.
Interesting outfits.
For your safety, throughout your flight with your restraints securely fastened. Please watch your children.
Again.
Para su seguridad, permanezcan sentados con el cinturón de seguridad ajustado y cuide de los pequeñitos.
Do not put on your flight glasses until instructed to do so by a crew member. One final reminder. Smoking and photography are never permitted on any Star Tours flight.
Damn.
If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask a Star Tours agent. You'll be boarding in just a few moments. Thank you.
And I'm going to go ahead and shut out my own. That was the introduction to Star Tours.
You know what? I forgot to cover eating. We did eat at two places, and we did the smart thing, actually. We did this. Basically, we went to, in Disney Tower Adventure for lunch, we went to Taste Pilot's Grill. And, we had their chicken nuggets with fries and two cups of water. We drank a lot of water during this trip, because, one, we couldn't really afford soda or any other kind of drink, and two, we really didn't. Water is better during the heat than anything else. Let's see. Plus the vitamin water, they sell for $4. I'm like, okay, we can get two for a fourth of that price at some place, depending on where you go. But, yeah, the we went over to Taste Pilot. Then we went to Plaza Inn after we hit Star Tours, and I shot a video of that. Here it is.
Okay, right now we're eating dinner at the Plaza Inn. Yeah, I got that. My knee's cut. She's now red.
I'm totally red.
She just whacked me across the shoulder. But, hey, you didn't see a slug bug. I'm just joking. But, yeah, I got off Star Tours, and she just calls me a big nerd. Well, duh, I love Star Wars. But, all I can say about Star Tours, it's, you gotta do it more than once.
Technically,
260
times, you
get all places. Oh, shoot. Well, basically, when we did, it went to Tatooine for the pod races. Then to that one planet. It's one from episode 2, where Jango Fett runs off to. I don't know the name of it, but we're tailed by him, and well, then we go to the Rebel Alliance rendezvous point, and well, that was it. Because apparently there's a there was a spy on board, a rebel spy on board. And, well, that was that part. And well, other than what we're going to be doing, we're going to be probably sitting here for a while until we have to go meet up with my sister. And that'll be the day. So, bye.
And that's how the day ended. Well, see, is there anything else that I may have left out? I got a lot of compliments on the shirt that I was wearing, which I'm currently wearing right now. It's the Chernobog from the Nine on Ball Mountain part of the first Fantasia movie. A lot of people are like, including cast members, are like, nice shirt. And I'm like thinking to myself, I even said it, the shirt's like 10 years old. And they're like, well, it's still a nice shirt. And I go, thank you. Because I remember I got it like about 10 years ago, back when I was still a cast member at Disneyland. I mean, when I saw it, I was like, ooh, I gotta have that shirt. It's so fucking cool. And it is. So, and also a lot of people, a lot of regular guests, especially a group of girls that we were on Grizzly River Run with, they liked the fact that my niece is wearing a they thought it was actually handmade by someone else. She made it herself. It's like a little beret type hat she was wearing, and she she also was wearing little cat ears that she made herself, as well as a camera. And as well as a dress, a little dress skirt thing that she made herself. And she likes, that's what my niece does. When she gets bored, she'll make things. She'll like, you know, crochet, you know, knit or something. And what she says is, what she didn't learn from her mother, or her, she calls it her Abby, because, you know, my sister's kids call my sister's mother Abby instead of grandma. But anyway, back on the trip that we had, is there anything I left out? Didn't really visit much of Paradise Pier. I'm not really a big fan of Paradise Pier area. Never was. I mean, they did change quite a bit of Disney's Garden's main entrance area. There was a train there, they took that out. The Golden Gate Bridge, I'm like, the Golden Gate Bridge, come on, the Golden Gate Bridge is the main icon of California. I mean, sure, it's up in San Francisco, but it's like, when you think of California, one of the things you think of California is the Golden Gate Bridge. And they took that out. I'm like, no. They also took out this big sun thing in the center. Like, it was near the center of the main entrance of DCA, and it was like a fountain that flowed water like over like a waterfall kind of thing, and it was good, but they took that out. And I just think a lot of things were taken out that shouldn't have been taken out. Let's see. What else is there? Well, some attractions were down. Indiana Jones is down because they're refurbishing it, frankly. What else? Well, whatever there is, I'll probably think of it another time, but... Okay, on the way home, we met my sister outside. And we waited for a bus. Didn't take long. It took like 5 minutes. And on the way home, I noticed there was some stuff that was... I remember back when I used to ride that bus, there was some stuff around that was no longer there. Or is now part of that area. Like, for instance, there's a place that's like, you know, literally a stone's throw away from here, from where I live. It's a Spanish market called Northgate. And what Northgate, and their distribution center is right there off of the 5 freeway at Magnolia. On the border between Anaheim and Fullerton. I guess it's a three-way borderline because Anaheim's on one part, Fullerton's on another, and Buena Park's on another part. But there's also a Chick-fil-A out there. I don't do the fact that the whole Chick-fil-A thing. Because of that, I don't like that place. Plus, it's like expensive for chicken. Come on, chicken's easy to come by. Let's see here. The bus takes a different route now. Instead of going through going down to the Buena Park Auto Center, driving, going left and going on the 5 and hopping back out to Santa Fe Springs. It goes through a little bit of Buena Park and and much of Santa Fe Springs. There's another little city there too. But it goes. Then when it came to an area near where I used to work for the security company I do at the church on Sundays, there was a place out there called Daily Foods. There was a distribution center of Daily Foods Incorporated, which is a Japanese-owned company from the Nippon Ham Incorporated Corporation in Japan. It's their American distributor, and there used to be two places I used to stop by to get something to eat on the way when I used to go on the way there. That was Jack in the Box, no longer there. And I don't know, three. Jack in the Box, AMPM, no longer there, or Coast Asian. And Carl's Jr. All those three are no longer there. There was a Motel 6, no longer there. A 76 station, no longer there. All those that I remember is the Lowe's, Dune Inn, I think it's called, and the Carmelita Truck Center. That's it. Nothing else is there. Let's see here. Oh, and in Buena Park, they're building a place that's going to be, they're trying to be like LA Live. Unless you're a big city, you're not. The only thing Buena Park has going for it is the fact that it's got Knott's Berry Farm. That's it. Now, and also some of my friends, a few of my friends live out there, but that's it. Let's see. Not much on the way to the, there's a Northgate Market where a shopping center that used to have a Circuit City. The Circuit City is now a TJ Maxx. A wholesale shoe warehouse is no longer there. trying to think what else. Not very much. When we got to the near or at the Green Line station, a guy got on. He was on one of the electric wheelchairs. Oh boy, did he reek! It was so bad. My niece took the hat that she knitted herself, folded up not once, not twice, but three times, and just covered her nose and her mouth. It was that bad. It woke my sister up. Nothing wakes my sister up. Or even earthquake doesn't wake my sister up. Nothing will, I would have thought. But this guy's stink. This guy's stench just, oh. And then when we were like, ugh. The fact that we were sitting up front, and we were like, ugh. It was bad. So, then we got home. And that was it. That was the day. So, I had a great time. I had a great time. I was able to forget all about the current bullshit that's going on in my life, and that was it. Hopefully I'll be able to share more videos like that with you. But until my next video, this is Lone Jedi saying thank you all for watching. See you all next time. Take care of yourselves.
You think you know me?